Enough waiting. I crave blood.
Never a dull moment. I have a lot on my mind, and, well, in it. Strange place for a button, especially one that doesn't work.
The disc appears in your mind's eye. Lazel sees it too and considers the vision.
Tirsu markings. Ancient. I recognize them, but I can't make sense. No. Wait. The texts are enciphered, but I've solved the pattern. It's a story. About Orpheus.
Your head buzzes in concert with Lazel's, but it hardly matters. Even without the connection, you'd recognize her discomfort.
A traitor. A dead one. This text is heresy. I can hardly bear to read it, let alone speak it. It is for the best.
Once again, you're...
More writings on Orpheus, the so-called Prince of the Comet. The Prince of the Comet, Part 1. So it was that we were free from Geich shackles and turned our blades on each other. The heavens were shattered, and one great empire was divided in two. Gith traveled to the Hells to broker help for her people, her cause. Vlakith would have you believe Mother Gith proclaimed her our queen. Lies. Gith made no such proclamation. Vlakith seized the Empire against the Mother's wishes. But Gith had nurtured a son. Orpheus, Prince of the Comet, the true heir. He knew Vlakith's treachery. Orpheus rallied Gith's honor guard and declared the throne for himself. The War of the Comet had begun. Disregard this drivel. Gith declared Vlakith Queen of the Empire and her own son defied her. Orpheus would have ceded control to the Geich. And so it is, a fabrication. A clever one, too, to masquerade as an ancient history. How many such stories could there be? And how many minds have been warped by them?
New sounds through the dampened dark oppression break. Is it the foe? That foul, contemptuous heel?
Some blood.
ready. Swift and lethal. You bow, or you break.
My ring lit up. Must have been linked to that button.
Indolence breeds madness.
Wits and blades, always sharp.
All right, what now? Strange place for a button, especially one that doesn't work.
Fiat Lux!
Strange place for a button, especially one that doesn't work. Strange place for a button, especially one that doesn't work.
That's curious.
What did that do? What did that do? What did that do? Strange place for a button. Especially one that doesn't work. Strange place for a button. Especially one that doesn't work.
She is cataloging Kuotuan fertility rituals.
Welcome back. Have you made any new discoveries?
seen anything like it, though. Is my species evolved?
What now?
Perhaps, but at such an accelerated rate.
No time to rest.
Enough time wasted. Battle awaits.
It simply shouldn't be possible. I greet you, child of the dark. How has your search for the mushrooms fared? These are fine specimens. It will only take me a moment to brew them to proper potency.
Ormeluon turns away to prepare the potion, lost in its own musings.
You must drink the entire draught. I can make no promises as to its taste. It will lower the psionic defenses around the lava. If I cannot remove it, I may still be able to tell you more about its origin.
Ormeluon watches you with cautious intensity. It expects doubt. It expects fear.
Only in that you may be a danger to yourself. What the potion may make you see or feel, I cannot determine. But unless you are already a step from death, it will not kill you.
The potion is disgusting beyond description. The only mercy is that it goes down quickly.
Not a drop left. Very good. As the potion influences your mind, you may find yourself acting irrationally. Try and stay focused.
The world loses its edges, its finer boundaries. You are fluid, but trapped like a creature suspended in amber. Dark holes bite at the edges of your vision, but the void cannot draw you in. The tadpole spasms, seizes. It's fighting the potion even harder than you are. Fear pierces your mind like knives of ice. The parasite digs deeper, as if it means to hollow out your skull. Blades lose their edge. You are stalwart, turning that tide of fear against itself. The parasite swells with power, more power than you have ever felt before. It surges and twists, lashing out against that which would dare to intrude. The parasite in your mind quiets, pleased with itself.
Ormeluon, are you well?
That lava is like nothing I have ever observed before. Its power is unsettling. You have my deepest apologies. The lava did not care for my intentions. Yet that power may grow beyond your control. I have another intermediate solution, if you are in need. I possess a ring of mind shielding. It prevents elder brains from noticing my presence. It will not remove the lava, but it will limit its influence, both positive and negative. I would offer it as a gift, but in truth, the ring is priceless. Is there anything you could offer me in turn?
We shouldn't cause trouble, Omeluum. There are enough threats down here in the Underdark.
Very well. I abhor violence, and would rather prevent it where possible. Here, it is yours. May it serve you as well as it has served me.
To deal with this abomination, nigh unthinkable. Yet even Vlakith herself could not deny the ring's merit.
Of course, the lava remains. Be ever vigilant of its growth.
How is your more personal research progressing?
Not the nutrition my species receives from other mines is difficult to emulate.
Worry not, friend. You'll find the key soon enough. Have you spoken with Skriss lately?
Yes. She is cataloging Corazon fertility rituals.
Oh. Well, perhaps after I finish my research here, I'll join you.
My friend!
Bibberban. Next time. More careful next time, for certain. Thank you for your help. Hey, should have waited for... Anyway, what were you saying? Hmm.